All right, I'm sure you know there are carbide coring bits and diamond core bits, but many of the most common questions we get is which core bit to use and what tools work with each. They've both been around for years, and frankly, sometimes they're a pain in the ass. I'm Nick from Ohio Power Tool. Let's talk about carbide and diamond core bits.
Typically, carbide core bits go into rotary hammer drills, and diamond core bits go into specialty core drills that are either hand or rig mounted. Most professionals have a hammer drill, and not everyone has a core drill, so sometimes the application can be troublesome. But don't worry, we got some options for you we'll talk about in a second. Coring is time consuming. Well, time consuming if you're not coring anything tougher than center block. Of course you want a smooth core and not blow out the concrete on the other side. And that's a good segue into talking carbide. Don't get me wrong, carbide is great. It cuts well, long lasting, and an overall great accessory for simply making a hole in concrete. However, it's pounding the concrete, the same way your chisel pounds the concrete when you want to remove it. So when it comes to coring, there are several solutions. So when you're coring into poured concrete, you'll inevitably hit rebar or steel. This will actually chip off the carbide segments, causing a much larger headache. If your segment pops off, now you're trying to cut through steel and carbide. Good luck with that one, buddy. If you insist on using carbide, the way around this is you core all the way to the steel or rebar, stop, then switch out your bit to the rebar cutter in drill only mode, knock that out, then put your carbide bit back in and continue coring. It does work and will save your carbide core bits, and that's great, but there is another option. Diamond core bits, and you don't need to put out $1,400 to $2,500 on a specialty core machine to use it. We carry quite a few solutions to diamond coring. We got wet core, dry, threaded barrel, etc. from Diamond Products, Core Bore, and DyeTech. There are many advantages to each type of coring, and eventually we'll do some in-depth coverage of that. For now, let's focus on dry coring with a diamond bit, because if you are comparing to carbide, we really are comparing to dry coring. Unlike the carbide, diamond bits can continue through that steel or rebar without the need of switching it out. This is because the bits are not pounding the concrete, they are technically grinding it. So grinding metal works pretty much the same. As you can imagine, it saves time. That's important if each hole takes 10 to 15 minutes and you've got multiple to do. But that isn't the only benefit with diamond coring, as you'll also gain quality. Often the pounding of the hammer drill has some not great consequences on the back of the hole. It'll blow out and you'll have a mess. Running utilities into someone's finished basement, this is not a great look. With diamond, there is no pounding. Since you're grinding, you'll get a nice clean core without the risk of blowing out the back end. Most of our customers know this, but maybe haven't invested in a core drill yet, so they make do with their hammer drill and carbide bits. Did you know you can still use a diamond core bit with a hammer drill? Yeah, it's real. DyeTech made an adapter for SDS Plus or SDS Max, and it works fairly well, but only if your drill has a rotate-only mode. All SDS Plus have this mode, but that's not the case with all the SDS Max. So you'll want to check that out first. Of course, it's great to have a dedicated core drill, but if you're not coring every day, it just wouldn't make sense.
Look, there's nothing wrong with coring carbide. We just want to let everyone know there are options. Often it doesn't matter what the backside of a hole looks like. Either way, we're here to help. You can shop all carbide and diamond core bits at ohiopowertool.com. If you can't find exactly what you're looking for, or this video is giving you more questions, just give us a call or leave it below in the comments. We'll be happy to lend a hand. Now before you go, subscribe to the channel and join us every week for more videos. Also, make sure you leave us a comment. Tell us what you're using as a coring solution. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.